currently in clinical trials, the clinical event committees are the gold standard. So how it works is each site must submit that an event occurred. And how sites determine that an event occurred is that it either happened at their site or a patient reports that it occurred when they follow up with the patient. And so you can imagine there are inherent difficulties with that, in that the patient either doesn't notify the site, the patient doesn't have documents from another hospital, they can't be obtained, and so adjudication can't happen. After a site does get notification that an event has happened, it's given to the CEC, the Clinical Event Committee, for adjudication. It's usually assigned to two different physician reviewers who review the event and the supporting source documents, and then determine whether the event meets a specific definition based on the clinical trial. Medicare claims offer a nationwide source of data that all patients above the age of 65 have. And so that's why it could be a useful source of data for particularly patients with cardiovascular problems, as they tend to be older. So I think that it offers the opportunity to monitor patients for certain outcomes, to monitor long-term without the cost necessary to keep sites active. So without having to pay a clinical trial coordinator at the site and the other additional costs keeping sites active, we can monitor long-term outcomes in patients and be reasonably confident that while we might not have the same clinical granularity available through physician adjudication, that it aligns well and that the numbers are similar. While we did exclude patients who were less than 65 and wouldn't qualify for Medicare, prior literature does suggest that they're older patients and so would be covered by CMS. So we chose CMS based on the availability, the large patient population that it would cover, and that most of our patients would be included in CMS data. Mortality, physician adjudication aligned very well with claims data. And if you think about it, it's not actually that surprising. If somebody has died, most people will agree that patient has died. However, for non-fatal outcomes, depending on the exact definition used by the physician adjudicators, and based on the definitions from the ICD-9 codes from claims data, they may or may not align as well. And so for some definitions, heart failure as a primary diagnosis, for example, that aligned very well with physician adjudication. And I wasn't completely surprised by that, because most of our physician adjudication definitions include that the patient has to be admitted with a primary diagnosis of heart failure. And so when we expanded that to a less specific definition for claims data, it detected a significantly greater number of events, which isn't surprising because those definitions did not align well. When the definitions align well, we saw that the claims data detected a similar number of events as physician adjudication, but when the less specific definitions were used, then claims detected a greater number of events. I don't think we'll ever get rid of CEC, ever, right? Because so for certain things, you have to have CEC. So for the FDA is gonna drive this a lot. So for device approval, for drug approval, you're gonna have that gold standard physician adjudication. And so this is more almost to supplement that and to allow for monitoring long-term, where previously it might have been cost prohibitive.